am I a candidate for a hair transplant? I've been taking Propecia, 1/4 tablet daily, and using Rogaine every day. However, my hairline has still been receding. I'm uncomfortable with my hairline and would like to know if I am a candidate for a hair transplant. I am 26.
Thank you for your question. You're 26 years old. You're asking, are you a candidate for a hair transplant? You describe in your question that you're taking a quarter of a tablet of finasteride every day, and you're taking minoxidil. And in spite of this regimen, your hairline continues to recede. So I'm interested in understanding, of course, why you've chosen to cut your dosage to a relatively low dosage. In medicine, we refer to this as a sub-therapeutic dose because there is established standards of how much dihydrotestosterone is reduced with 1 milligram a day of finasteride. Now, it may be because you're concerned about what everyone else is concerned right now is about long-term sexual side effects, but you're probably not doing that much good by taking such a low dose. You may not, if your hair follicles are susceptible to DHT, you may not be reducing enough DHT to make a difference. As far as to answer the question about a hair transplant, this is a natural question because when you look at your options beyond medications, when you go online, you see that there's so much information about transplants, and doctors who do transplants will always boast about numbers of grafts and how much they can do and how great and natural their transplants look. For many years, it was generally advised not to do transplants on men in their 20s, because if the onset of hair loss is in the 20s, then the limitations of a transplant may prevent getting the optimal result for someone in their 20s. As you get older, you tend not to need as much hair because of just general societal norms. And you know, when you look at people in their 40s and 50s, there's more than 40 to 50% of men will have hair loss, and you can get a transplant and not have to have a full head of hair. But one thing that more people are learning about is something we've developed that is called hair regeneration. Now, I'm telling you this because it is filling a much needed void between medications and transplantations, and it's something that we're treating more and more people who are coming to us from all over the world. What this is a development of a process to reverse hair thinning without taking medication, without doing surgery, but rather with a combination of a material called extracellular matrix developed originally for wound healing combined with a material that comes from your own blood called platelet-rich plasma. Platelet-rich plasma is essentially the key elements and growth factors necessary for wound healing. And what is done with platelet-rich plasma in this combination are injections into the scalp and a process that we've developed which involves a formulation, a combination, a series and methods of treatment that is all done at one time. It's a one-time procedure. And we've been able to get successful results in about 100% of male pattern hair loss patients, which is remarkable. We've treated people who were taking finasteride and were still losing hair. And of course, we've treated many people. In fact, the majority of our male patients don't take finasteride at all. So hair regeneration has become quite a significant benefit for men with male pattern hair loss. And we're at a point now where we have so many hundreds and hundreds of patients that we actually have seen that the results for most men up to a certain point of degree of hair loss will actually have results that exceed the results of hair transplantation. Now that really says a lot. And it's basically because if we're able to go to the hair follicles and they're already grouped together in the right way, Mother Nature already created this, and by thickening those hairs, the amount of coverage you get on your scalp is considerably more than you can get with a hair transplant. Hair transplant, you can only move so many hairs. There are limits in the number of hairs you can move. There are limits in the number of hairs that will actually survive. And there's a lot of collateral hair loss for patients who have existing hair. This is never stressed enough, that existing thinning hairs that once contributed to the overall look of coverage are sacrificed when you do hair transplant, because you're making little openings or stabs in the skin that exceed 1,000+ points depending on the number of grafts. You're going to get a lot of collateral damage. Now, in the past, there was something that as surgeons we accepted because there was no alternative. So our strategy is first do hair regeneration, restore whatever is possible, and stabilize and prevent the progression. This one-time injection appears to have benefit for 3 to 5 years. There's a small subset of patients that we actually do a secondary injection for who are more advanced. And if we're able to get back hair in areas where the scalp appeared smooth and we're able to inject them again, we seem to be able to build on top of that. But this is part of the art of the of clinical care. And we see our patients every 3 months, so we're really very, very methodical about making sure that we are able to measure our results as objectively as possible. Combination of trichoscopy and digital high-resolution photography. So, that being said, when you explore your options, I think hair transplant is something you should try to defer as much as possible. Talk to your physician or whoever writes you for your finasteride about this thing, what I mentioned about the sub-therapeutic dosing, and either take it the proper way or don't take it at all, because I don't think you're going to get much benefit. I mean, that's my opinion. Clinically, I don't know if it would really make that much of a difference. Also, when you cut a pill in fours, you're really not getting a quarter dosage in each part of the pill. It's not, the manufacturers, pharmaceuticals don't make their pills like that. So it's very important that you really understand the physiology of hair loss as much as you can before you make these decisions. But understanding that there is now an alternative called hair regeneration, which can stabilize progression as well as thicken existing hair, you might be able to hold off having a hair transplant for a while, or if at all. Majority of our patients, as a side note, actually, once they've had the injection, feel very satisfied and decide not to have hair transplant. This is something I was actually surprised about, but I realized that for a lot of the patients who come to us, there was a certain threshold at which point where they were okay. And then after they passed that threshold, they decided to seek attention. So once we got their hair back to where they were before that threshold, it seems like they're satisfied and they don't feel the urgency of having to have a hair transplant. A lot of men do hair transplants purely out of desperation. And desperation is a terrible reason to make any decision. So education, learn more, and then make a decision based on education and about your medical therapy as well as hair regeneration. But I would dissuade you from doing a transplant. I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.